Hi, my name is Jose Sandoval. I'm 18 years old. And I was born in Mexico. I was brought here when I was 8 years old because my aunt was dying of cancer and my uncle really needed my mom to take care of her 7 kids. So we were brought here for that reason. And coming here, I always knew I was undocumented but didn't know what it meant. So it wasn't until high school until it really became a problem. I got really involved in speech and debate, which was one of the things I loved to do. And I ended up winning a lot of first place trophies for it, and was gonna go to a different state to compete, but my mom didn't let me. And one of the issues was for that the fear of a lot of traveling out of state because of the fear of getting deported, and that was her main thing. She didn't want to be separated from me, and she wanted to stay here because all of our family was here. So at some point, I let it go. I knew it was something I wanted to do, but I kept moving and just going through school. Was really involved on campus. Started tutoring little kids when I was in a freshman because I love kids. But started doing that, and then it didn't really hit me what the struggles of undocumented students really face. So I was trying to apply for universities, and I was nominated for a full scholarship to UCLA and UC Berkeley. I was 10 kids nominated by my principal. And I went to the event, and when I got there, I turned in the whole paperwork, and I was really excited because, first of all, it was just an accomplishment. I had a 4.0 GPA in my school, and I worked so hard for it. And so I got there, and as soon as I got there, one of the questions was, they asked me, where are you a citizen? And I told them no, and at that moment, they pulled me aside, and at some point, the guy let me know, I'm sorry, but our organization does not support undocumented students. And my heart just dropped. And it dropped because I knew of all that I was doing. I knew of how hard I had worked to get there. I was going to not only high school, but community college in the night in order to get to where I wanted to go. And it hurt me so much to like know that they allow you to build all these goals in high school, but they don't allow you to realize them. So at some point, I was about to cry, but I told myself that I was gonna, he asked me if I wanted to stay there for an hour and 30 minutes, which was the whole process, knowing that I wasn't gonna be eligible for it. So what I decided to do is I contained my tears and decided to stay there. And I stayed there because I was gonna show them what they were about to lose. I knew that I was talented enough to be eligible for that, and just, I showed them just stay there and show them that I was just like other kids and I was equal and I was trying to fight for something and trying to fight for education and trying to get a higher education just like anyone else. So I stayed there, and what really made me excited about this is that after he pulled me aside, and one of the things we had to do is just a lot of interviews, and he said I did an amazing job and that it wasn't his fault that the whole organization did not support it, and he knew I was going to have a great future. And after that, I told my principal about it, and what she ended up doing is she collected a lot of her friends, ended up giving a lot of donations to me in order to go to school. And now I'm a freshman at UC Berkeley, studying molecular toxicology and pre-business with a minor in theater. And it feels great to accomplish all that, but recently I became open about my status a month ago. And the reason I became open about my status was because I joined the WAF for a campaign for an American dream. And I realized that I was doing so much, not only for myself, but for the community. I was working in Occupy Oakland and Berkeley, and I was a really big fighter for environmental issues. I helped ban the bag in Berkeley. And I saw all the things that I was working for, and no one knew that behind all these issues and behind the person, they stopped fighting for their rights, because at some point they do not affect me, because I don't have the legal rights to be affected by them, but I was helping them out to make a world a better place for them. And so I wanted to show them that there is a story behind me and that I'm also fighting other issues. And so I became open about my status, and everyone was very accepting. And it was awesome to see, honestly, all the help you got from students, all the help you got from friends, and not only friends, from other people in the community, just accepting of all the kind of stuff. But what I'm here for now is just, because I became open about my status, is I'm urging other students to become open about their status, because essentially connecting faith to the undocumented struggle and knowing what you do for your community and how hard these students have worked, essentially it's what's going to help to pass the Dream Act or legislation like this, just connecting on a more deeper level than just knowing that there's undocumented students and hearing from what media says about undocumented people in general. And now I'm here trying to encourage people who are my age who think essentially what I was thinking when I joined university. Essentially, I was thinking I have 4 years and I still have that time to get those papers and all this kind of stuff. But no, it's you got to fight now because in 4 years you don't know what will happen. So start the fight now, and that's what I'm trying to encourage. Start when you have time in order to build that to when those 4 years or when you're graduating from high school, graduating from university, so you have a foundation settled. Thank you so much.